Welcome, welcome dear student, in one another session of Pharmaceutics First Practical. Myself Darshana Sandeep Shinde, and let's move towards our today's experiment. Our today's experiment is experiment number 14. Title of our experiment is to prepare, evaluate and submit 25 ml surgical chlorinated soda solution BP. Or it has also synonym Dakin's solutions. Learning outcomes of our today's session. After watching this video, students should be able to develop the intellectual skills just to understand the chemical reaction involved in the formation of the chlorine and to develop some motor skill like skill of measurement and skill for dissolution. Let's move toward the theory part of our solutions. Now we see the what are the solutions. Let's introduction to the solutions. Solution is a physically and chemically homogeneous mixture of two substances. Main consideration in the formulation of solution is solubility of medicament in the solvent. A solution. The component of a solution present in the larger quantity is referred to as a solvent, while other present in a smaller amount is known as the solute. The true solution, the solute is present in the molecular or ionic form, and hence true solution is referred as a molecular dispersion. The various excipient used in the dosage form for its stability as well as to improve the patient compliance. These are the solubilizing agents, viscosity controlling agents, buffers, antioxidants, colors, flavors and preservatives. These are the agents which are used to as an excipient in the dosage forms. Then next we see the different forms of the solution. That means very soluble solution, freely soluble means what? This is the descriptive terms, and in these parts of solute, per one part of the solute, that means how much part is get soluble. Very soluble means less than one part is remain unsoluble. Freely soluble means from 1 to 10 parts remain unsoluble. Soluble means from 10 to 30 parts. Sparingly soluble means from 30 to 100 parts get unsoluble. Slightly soluble, here the concentration is increased. 100 to 1000 part is not soluble. Very slightly soluble means from 1000 to 10,000 part is not soluble. Insoluble or practically insoluble means more than 10,000 part is remain unsoluble. Then different techniques for the solubility enhancement are solubilization using the surfactant, consolvency, then pH modification, complexation, hydrotropy, chemical modification of the drug. First of all, we see solubilization using the surfactant. A solubilization may be defined as the dissolution of poorly soluble solute molecules in the water in presence of surfactant, forming the thermodynamically stable solution. Surfactants are molecules with the well-defined polar and non-polar region that allow to aggregate in the solution, form a micelles. Solubilization occurs by solute dissolving in or being the absorbed into the micelles, that is cresol with the soap solution. This is the example of that. Then next method is consolvency. In that, consolvency is the process of enhancing the solubility of a very poorly soluble drug in the water by adding water miscible solvent in which the drug is very soluble. Then the solvent is employed in achieving this goal are called as the co-solvents. The enhanced solubility through the consolvency is the however regarded as the result of independent solubility of the substance in each co-solvent. Example of it, co-solvent as ethanol, sorbitol, glycerin, propylene glycol, etc. These are used as a co-solvent. The next method is pH modification method. In this method, solubility of weak acid and weak bases can be markedly affected by the pH. Hence, solubility of the drug, which are either weak acid or weak bases, may be influenced by the verification in the pH. Example of it, strong solution of ammonium acetate. The next method is complexation. In this, complexation is association between the two or more molecule to form a non-covalent base complex that has higher solubility than the drug itself. Organic compounds have a tendency to associate with each other. Example of it, complexation of iodine and potassium iodide in the iodine solution. The main consideration involved in the employing the complexation techniques are, first, the amount of a drug which can be dissolved by specific complexing agent, then whether the resulting complex is safe, stable and therapeutically effective. These are the techniques while main consideration, or these are the main consideration while employing the complexation method. Then hydrotropy. The term hydrotropy designate in increasing solubility of a drug in water owing to the presence of large amount of additives. Example of it, increased solubility of caffeine in presence of sodium benzoate and theophylline in presence of sodium salicylate. This one is example. Second, the possible mechanism of hydrotropy is considered to be the solubilization, complexation and co-solvency also. The next method is chemical modification of the drug. The method is based upon preparing the water-soluble derivative of a poorly soluble drug. Example of it, alkaloids are poorly soluble. Their derivative with the acids, these are alkaloidal salts, are fairly soluble. Example, drug like the corticosteroids have been esterified to produce the water-soluble derivatives. Other important problem involved in the development of formulation for the liquid preparations are stability, sterility, organoleptic qualities, viscosity, tonicity, specific gravity. These are the other problem while making the preparations. These are the filter plate which are used for the filtration purpose. In this filter plate, we see that different plates are used. These plates are contained the small holes, and from this, by applying the pressure, we can filter our solution. This is the metafilter which can be used for the clarification purpose rather than the filtration one. Now we see the apparatus required for our today's experiment. Conical flask, glass beaker, glass rod, volumetric flask, dispensing balance and spatula. Then we see the formulation table. The formulation table consists of a formula of our preparation mentioned in a specific book. Here, the formula for our preparation is a boric acid, 4 gram for 1000 ml, chlorinated lime, 18.8 gram for 1000 ml, sodium carbonate 37.6, and purified water is QVS to 1000 ml, that is quantity sufficient to 1000 ml. This is formula for 1000 ml, but we have to prepare only the 25 ml so that we calculate a factor. Factor can be calculated by the quantity required upon quantity given. Our quantity required is 25 and quantity given is 1000. Our factor is 0.25. So, by this factor, we can multiply the quantity given section and we ultimately get the quantity taken. Boric acid, for an example, 4 into 0.025, we get the 0.1 gram. In this way, boric acid is used as a bactericide, chlorinated lime is used as a disinfectant, sodium carbonate is used as a bleaching agent, and purified water is used as a vehicle. Then, we move toward the stepwise procedure.
In this stepwise procedure, some reaction we have to take a consideration while making this preparation. Calcium chlorhypochlorite, a principal constituent of a bleaching powder, and decompose on the addition of our water. This is a calcium chlorhypochlorite. When it is converted into calcium hypochlorite and calcium chloride, when it is get decomposed with water. In react with the sodium carbonate, this is a calcium chlorohypochlorite. When it get react with the sodium carbonate, we get the sodium hypochlorite and calcium carbonate. This calcium chloride from the first one reaction and sodium carbonate, this is the product of the second reaction. They, when they react together, there is a formation of sodium chloride and calcium carbonate. Bleaching powder always contains some amount of calcium hydroxide. This react with the sodium carbonate. This is our calcium hydroxide. This is sodium carbonate. We get the calcium carbonate and plus sodium hydroxide. Sodium hypochlorite hydrolysis in the solution to produce the sodium hydroxide. Sodium hypochlorite plus 2H2O, it gives the sodium hydroxide and hypochloric acid. Hence, filtrate is very alkaline and too caustic for the worms. This the addition of the boric acid react with the sodium hydroxide and neutralize it. Hence, the finished product almost neutral and buffered out. So that's why we added the boric acid for the neutralization of the solution. Then we go through the stepwise procedure. The pH for the solution is 9.5, that is alkaline solution is stable one. Too much alkalinity rendered irritation to the tissue. Sodium borate forms act as a buffer and prevent the further hydrolysis. Bleach filter paper guards the loss of the chlorine and also the color change. First of all, dissolve the sodium carbonate in the water. Add the solution gradually with the constant trituration to the previous powdered chlorinated lime. Then shake it constantly for almost 10 minutes. Then decant or filter it through the bleach powder or bleach powder, filter paper. Then dissolve the boric acid in the filtrate. Category as a bactericide, and we should label as a for external use only. Storage, it should be stored in a cool place away from the light. Content, its contents are available. Chlorine contents between the 0.5 or 0.50 to 0.55 percentage weighed by volume calculated as a chlorine. Then we next move on to the laboratory for the practical session.
Welcome students in a pharmaceutics first laboratory. In this session we see the how to prepare the Daking solution, or it is also known as the surgical chlorinated soda solution BP. Let's see the apparatus required for our and chemical requirements for our today's preparation. In our chemical section we need the calcium carbonate, boric acid and chlorinated lime and purified water. In apparatus section we see we have to require a modern vessel for triturate the chlorinated lime, beaker, measuring cylinder, and this is filtrating assembly. Start the preparation. First of all, we triturate the chlorinated lime. Triturate it. Now its particle size is fine because they will collect in a filter paper. Take a beaker. In that beaker, take a little bit quantity of purified water. Into this, add the sodium carbonate. And stir it. To this add little bit of water. Then add this triturated
chlorinated lime. Shake it very vigorously, add very vigorously. Checking vigorously 10 minutes. We decant the filter or decant off filter the filtrate. For the filtration purpose, we have used the bleach filter paper. We set the assembly. This is the bleach filter paper. We get the filtrate. This filtrate is transparent one. In this filtrate we add the boric acid. Boric acid is important to reduce the alkalinity or to maintain the tissue alkaline. By the boric acid, our product is become neutral one. Before that, our solution is alkaline, and boric acid helps to our solution to neutral one. Boric acid is totally mixed, then finally make the final volume. We finally make up the volume 25 ml. See, our solution is clear one. It is the volume is net 25 ml. Odor is odorless and clear color. It do not have any color. It's a color one. That means our solution has passes the all the evaluation test. And then we fill this our preparation into the final container. That is a amber color bottle. Our preparation for first of all, it's alkaline. With the help of the boric acid, it is being neutral. For that purpose, we have to submit our preparation into the amber color bottle, protected from the light. Then we move towards the labeling section, labeling and evaluation table section.
Now we move towards the observation and evaluation table. Observation and evaluation table should be maintained as. It should contain the name of the preparation, test, specification and observation. Name of our preparation is surgical chlorinated soda solution BP. Test and description. We see that in a practical session, the description is clear one. We confirm that test. Color is colorless. We also confirm that test. Odor. Odor is odorless. We also confirm that test. And volume, we make the 25 ml. All the specification we should see in the during the while preparing the solutions. This is the, by this way we maintain this observation and evaluation table. Then next segment is the labeling of the formulation. Labeling should be done in this manner. This is the label. It should contain the name of our preparation, that is the surgical chlorinated soda solution BP. Then net content or volume of your preparation at the top right hand side of the preparation, 25 ml here written. Then we write the each 25 ml contain or each ml contain. Here we mention each 25 ml contain boric acid 0.1 gram, chlorinated lime 0.47 gram, sodium carbonate 5.94 gram and purified water QS to 25 ml. Category of our solution is the antibacterial or bactericide. It should be stored in a cool place away from the light. That means we have to store in a amber color bottle. Then label should as the it is a for external use only. It should be mentioned and it should be highlighted with the proper color. Then other manufacturing specification like the manufacturing license number, manufacturing batch number, manufacturing date of our preparation, manufacturing or expiry date of our preparation, maximum retail price, and the last at the bottom of your label you should mention the name and address of the manufacturing. All the specifications should be mentioned on the label. Then we move toward the result. How we write the result? The result should be written as 25 ml of surgical chlorinated lime BP is submitted in a, it should store in a cool place away from the light with the neat labeled. In this way we mention our result. In the next section we see the questions regarding this experiment. First one, why boric acid is added in the chlorinated soda solution? We see that boric acid is neutralized our solution and carried out the reaction. That's why we added the boric acid. And the second one is the state the pH of the surgical chlorinated solution. This pH should be maintained alkaline pH. The ideal pH is 9.4 ml. That should be maintained in our solution. In this way, we finish our experiment number 14, that is the surgical solution of chlorinated lime. Thank you very much for attending this practical session.